One reason the Big Ten first chose to delay the season was because of the concern about student athletes developing heart inflammation or myocarditis after being diagnosed with COVID.
We're joined by via Zoom live by Dr. Dinesh Kalra. He's a cardiologist at Rush Medical College. Thanks for joining us, Doctor.
Pleasure to be here, Ben.
Let's start with the potential impacts that COVID has on the heart. What have you been seeing?
Well, you know, when COVID first started, all of us thought it was only a respiratory virus. And as time has moved on, we've begun to realize that it really can do a number on the heart. We have patients in the ICUs who are unable to be extubated because their hearts become weak. And then even after people recover, we're seeing lingering inflammation and effects on the heart. So this is really a continuing story where the heart may be affected earlier on or even later on. So we are keeping a very close eye on these people.
Doctor, when it comes to athletes, if you have a child, you may have a child, a son, a daughter, or whatever, would you let them play sports? National, Big Ten, college level, whatever. Would you let them play sports right now during this pandemic?
Yeah, you know, so the data on that is not clear. If you want my personal opinion at this point, I would be a little reluctant. And because the sports, especially college level athletic sports, involve a lot of close contact. So that's just my personal opinion. There's guidelines, people are making guidelines, but these keep changing as data keeps coming in. All we have at the moment is these small studies showing that when athletes do get COVID and recover, there are still some athletes down the road, 2 or 3 months down the road, that are harboring inflammation in the heart. And that just makes you wonder what the long-term effects of this can be. So it's really a question we haven't answered yet.
So you don't know?
Correct. We don't know. We're in the blind here, and we need more data. And I think I have to commend the Big Ten on doing that. They are starting a registry where they're going to track these people. Not only are they going to screen everybody every day with a point-of-care test, which is commendable, but they're going to track the folks who've gotten COVID and follow them down the road for months to see what happens to these people. Is this a relatively safe diagnosis in these young people, or are there folks who are going to get really sick down the road? We don't know.
But for now, it's a real-life experiment. Back to those issues that can still present for months after a person recovers from COVID, one of the arguments we hear is, well, people who are healthy, people who are young, they can fight it off. It impacts them much the same way a cold would, but it is those longer-term health issues and the effect on the heart that certainly would impact student athletes, right?
That is absolutely correct. So we don't have a ton of data for your usual respiratory viruses, like when you get influenza. How often do those people get myocarditis? We think it's small, but we have never really tracked those people carefully. With COVID, this seems to be a tricky virus. I mean, this causes a lot of inflammation, not just in the heart, but in the blood vessels and other organs. And your body is trying to mount an inflammatory response to destroy the virus. And that, in turn, is causing collateral damage to the heart. So we're just beginning to see that this persists for a while. Whether or not that's going to mean something in the long run, we don't know. We think it might, so that's why we're being extra cautious.
Right. Dr. Dinesh Kalra, thank you so much. Be safe, be well.
Thank you.